Hey everybody, and welcome back to another exciting and informative episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. This episode is part 2 in our 2-part series on creating scribble and stroke text. In the previous episode, we animated some stroke text by creating shapes from text and then adding in a trim paths and made just a few adjustments. We also added in some accent lines using some shape layer paths. Now, if you haven't seen that episode, I highly recommend you do that now, because we're going to be building on what we learned last time. In this episode, we're going to finish off our scribble animation and also add in a pencil effect for our final look. Please like this video so I can make that YouTube algorithm happy. Share this episode and my channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. And click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. And please, leave me a message in the comments below and let me know if this episode helped you out. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers, and it's guaranteed to make you a shape layer wizard. The link to that course, as well as to the project files for this 2-part series, are in the description below. I've also included a table of contents so you can go back and rewatch sections that you found difficult. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Keep in mind that this is part 2 of a 2-part series. In the previous episode, we created our stroke text and accent marks, and we're picking up right where we left off. If this information is confusing, check out the previous tutorial first. Highlight this layer for Jeff Knight. I'm going to right-click Create, Create Masks from Text. If you open this up, you can see our masks. And again, it labels it for you by letter based on the order that your characters are in your text. So now let's go up to Effect. I'm going to choose Generate Scribble. And notice that only the J fills in for now. It's because our scribble is set to single mask. Let's just change that to all masks. Your fill type, you have several options. I would just leave it to inside, but just so you know, kind of play with some of these. See the different looks that you can get. Some of these look very similar. I just leave it at the default inside. I'm going to change the stroke width to 0.5, so that way it's really light. Click this end percentage. This is very similar to trim pass. It has a start and end percentage. So hit U to bring up our keyframe. Go for 2 seconds. Change this end percentage to 0. And then if you watch it play back, that's basically how it's going to write on. But there's still a few more things we need to do to this first. Just play this. You can see how your text continues to move. That's because of this wiggle type right here. You have smooth, jumpy, and static. Now, if you choose something like jumpy or smooth, you have this option for wiggles per second. So you can make it move slower, or you can make this a higher value. You can get some crazy results. It's going to limit how many wiggles per second to 30. I'm going to choose static. See how I have this weird gap on my K? You can adjust this random C to smooth some of that out. So now if we turn on our shape layer and our mask layer for the text, we can see how the outline will border our text. I have my stroke width set to 3. I'm going to change this to 1. Okay, so let's do the same thing with our 7-minute AE tutorials. This is our fill. So again, we're going to right click, create masks from text, go up to effect, generate scribble. We have our scribble set to single mask. We want to include all masks. See whether our A, O, and our R have holes within the letters, but they're filled in. Set your scribble to all masks using modes, and that will open up those holes in your text. Go down to stroke width, change this to 0.5, change our wiggle type to static. Go to the 2-second mark and click our end percentage. Click U to open up our keyframes. Go to the beginning of the layer and make that 0%. Turn on our stroke layer, which is this shape layer right here. I'm going to leave my stroke at 3 just so you can see the difference between having strokes of different weights. So this layer will have a stroke of 3, and the Jeff Knight layer will have a stroke of 1. And then we need to line up our 7-minute AE stroke and our 7-minute AE fill right here. We don't need our actual text layers anymore, so I'm just going to delete those. Make each one of your words a specific color. So I'll make Jeff Knight's yellow. I'll make my 7-minute AE tutorials orange. And so that way it's not quite as confusing. If you notice, this line is a little bit too perfect. And if we turn back on our accent here, we can see how those lines are too perfect. A good way to get a pencil look is to use an effect called Roughen Edges. Let's go over to our effects and presets and type in Roughen and double click that. And I'm going to choose Shift Command H, and that will allow us to see what we're doing without seeing things like binding boxes and mask pass and things like that. Since we added the roughen edges, our lines went away. So let's make some changes. Change this edge type from roughen to spiky. And then I want to make my border 1. We can change our complexity to 5. That way it thickens it up just a little bit. We want our accent lines also to animate on. So let's open this up. Click Contents, Add Trim Paths. We're going to make it a 2-second animation. So at 2 seconds, we're going to make our end percentage 100. At the beginning, We're going to make it zero, change our trim multiple shapes from simultaneous to individual so it comes on one at a time. It doesn't necessarily go in order. I'm going to just solo this layer so you can see it better. So you see it's kind of going out of order here. Well, that's because trim paths will trim the paths in the order that they're stacked. So I'm going to just turn back on my mask visibility real quick to make sure our paths are in the right order. So this is our first path. And then we want this path right here to come on next. It's actually path 3. So we can move that underneath path 1. We want this one to come on next, which is path 11. You have to do this by hand unless you do this from the beginning in the exact order. So I'm going to put 10 underneath 6. 7 go underneath 10, and then these look like they're in the right order. So we watch that play back. We see now everything kind of goes in the right order. However, I want them to go in different directions. This path 1 looks good to me, but now I want this path to come from a different direction. So remember, you can choose reverse path direction. And so this curved path, I like the way that goes up, but I want this one to come from the left. So we're going to reverse that path. Moving forward, that looks good. Actually want it to be this one. So we're going to move that up. Again, we want this to come from the left. We'll reverse that direction. That one's right. And it looks like the rest of these are animating on the right way. Pull back out and just watch it play back real quick. And that's exactly how we want it to go. Turn everything back on, and we want our lines to come on first. Go forward about, we'll say like 6 frames. Then we want to bring in our Jeff Knight, and then maybe another 10 frames, something like that. And now we can apply this roughen edge that we created for our accents. If you just command C to copy that, and let's go to our shape layer for Jeff Knight and the shape layer for 7 minute AE tutorials. Just paste that on. You kind of get that penciled look. Solo this Jeff Knight layer. You can see it's a big difference. I want my stroke to come on more fully before my scribble starts. So Jeff Knight starts at 6 frames. Let's go forward 4 frames. These two solids here and move those down. So where our stroke comes on first, and then our scribble won't really start filling in anything until some of these letters are filled in better. I'm just going to keep going on this accent layer. I'm going to create another path and just start adding in some for the 7 minute AE tutorials. You don't do quite as many as we did up on Jeff Knight. You can make as many of these as you want. So watch this playback. And this looks pretty good. This is exactly what I'm looking for. And that is how you create scribble and stroke text by creating masks and shapes from text. Now, just to recap, to create scribble text, first create masks from text. Then go to Effect, Generate, Scribble. Set your masks to include all masks, or all masks using modes in case your characters have holes in them, like with A's, R's, O's, and so on. Adjust your stroke width to the look that you want. Choose your fill type. Inside is always a good bet. We didn't cover this, but you can also change the color of your scribble, adjust the opacity of the effect, and change the angle. So give these options a try as well and see what you can come up with. Choose your wiggle type. If you choose jumpy or smooth, you have this wiggles per second option, which allows you to speed up or slow down the movement of the effect. Choosing static will disable all movement from the effect. If you get gaps in your scribble, you can adjust the random seed to fix the issue. And finally, animate the scribble on using the end percentage, increasing the value from 0 to 100%. This is a really cool effect, and I hope you learned something along the way. I hope this tutorial helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. Please share this episode and my channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. And please leave me a message in the comments below and let me know if this tutorial helped you out. Hopefully you learned something new and useful. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers, and it's guaranteed to make you a shape layer master. The link to that course, as well as to the project files for this two-part series, are in the description below. If you haven't seen last week's episode, I highly recommend you do that right now. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.